Today in this class we discuss about the advanced Excel with formula, and first become we have discussed from the basic, and we discuss about the file menu bar. Last class we discussed about the Excel fundamental topics, just like what is the Excel used and everything. And today we discuss in the file menu bar, but before starting the file menu bar, we need to discuss about the selection, because selection is the very important part in the Excel. So I have just created the some sample data through the RAND between formula, and we have selection method topic. So this is the my data and need to selection, because if you not select the data, you can't apply anything. If you want to apply pivot, need to selection. If you want to apply any formatting, any colors, any type of the data formatting, need to selection. You want to apply the filter, need to selection. You want to apply the charts, so need to selection. So selection is the very important part in the Excel. So first discuss about the selection method. So this is the data and want to select the data. So if you want to select, if you select the data from your mouse pointer, you can click here and hold the click here and move the mouse here. Your data will be selected. But you select from the mouse, so one is the shortcut, one way is the shortcut. First click the first cell and press the shift key. Second the last cell. I repeat, click on the first cell, press the shift key, and click on the last cell. You can select the all your data. You can also use the vice versa. Just like click the last cell, press the shift, and click on the first cell. So this is a simple basic concept. If you click here, when you click it, cursor will be moved. But if you press the shift, when you click, your selection will be moved. Okay? This is the mouse pointer. If you want to select from the keyboard, so click on the starting point, press the shift, and you can use the arrow key. And your data will be selected. But you want to select in one shot, because if your data have a large data, that time you have select manually one by one, that take the more time. So you have select the just press Control A. Yeah, Control A, select all. You can select the all data. So Control A trigger the in the home menu bar have a find and select. Here is the go to a special and current region. So Control A shortcut of the current region. So in the data have a blank row, your Control A select above of the blank row, completely blank. If you in the row have any one cell data, then you can select your complete data. But your any cell, a complete cell will be blank. Then select, if you press the Control A, current region, select the above of the blank row. Okay, and same is the column. I have insert the blank column. That time I press the Control A, select the data before of the blank row, and completely blank. If you have the any type of the data, that time select the all. So this is the problem. If you have the data, after the data have some miscellaneous data, a rough data like that, that time you have select the data, your completely data will be select, including this rough data. This is the problem. I want to select only for my heading, so need to insert the blank row after then selected. Yeah, other one way, we can use the control shift down arrow, right arrow and down. What is the control shift? So see here, if you want to go in the last, I want to go to the last data. Then if you have go through go like that one by one, to take the time. If your data have a 10,000, 10 lakh something, that time we use the press the control and press the down arrow. Okay, press the control key and press the down arrow. When you press the down arrow, go to the last of the your data. Okay, if you right, up, left, so your cursor will be start to end. But remember, this is the not a start to end, this is the start to sequence. Just like this is the fill sequence. Where is the blank row, blank cells? Then if you press the control down arrow, your data will be stopped here, because this is the break the switch. So when you press control and the arrow key, down, left, up, anything, so press the sequence key, press the sequence, follow the sequence, fill and blank. Like that, there is the blank, and now we have pressed the control down, we can go to the last of the data. Okay, so if you have the data, the more and more blank row, blank cells, and when you want to go to the last of data, we have two options. Okay, press the control and you can go to the last used cell. Okay, and secondly, it is the address bar. Go to the address bar, enter the cell address, just like A65000, A10 lakhs, press the enter, go to the A65000 cells, and now we have press the control up. You can go to the last cell of the data. Okay, it's clear. And if you want to select your data, go to the last and just press the control shift home. You can select the complete data, control shift one. But remember, if we use the same from the starting of the data, control shift and, then you can select it, but select the used cell, completely used cell, because this is no data, but selected because we have used that, type the roughly data. So select the used cell. So if you want to select with control and home and, so do not use the control and, go to the first last cell of your data and then press the control shift home. Your data will be completely selected. Okay? Okay, now I want to select the multiple cell. I want to select the multiple cell, not a sequence, according to me. That time we have pressed the control button, control key, and click where you want to select, your data will be selected. Anywhere you have clicked, your data will be selected. But remember, this selection only for edit the data and format the data. You cannot copy the data. If you want to try to copy, this action not work on the multiple selections. But I want to copy the multiple data, to have a one rule. So like that, we have select here A, C, E, G, and R. Now we have copy a data, because this is sequentially. When I select the A5. If I, in the 5 row, can't copy that. When you want to try the copy, we have need to selection also like above. Okay, now we are copy. Like that, we have select the A2 4 and next selection A2 3. We can't select. So maintain the sequence where the select the first, like that select the second. Okay, we have select here. Now we have. Okay. We have select the multiple cell and between different number of differences, column differences. But when you paste your data will be paste sequentially, right? And we have this method also work on your sheets. We have the new files and we have insert the many sheets here. I want to type one date, the A1, the every sheet the same A1. So if you have to do the manually like that, there is a date and there is a date here, and also date and date here, right? But this is the one by one manual. So if you have this type the date and same data, same location, the every sheet. So first click, press the shift key and press on the last of your sheet. When you press the last of your sheet will be grouped and select the every sheets. Now if I have the any type of the work in the sheet 1, also do in the sheet 2, sheet 3, sheet 4, sheet 5. Every sheet, same location, same work. Like that, we have type here date and here is the insert the date. Sorry. Right? We have auto fit your date data. See here, see in the sheet 2, in the sheet 3, sheet 4, sheet 5. Okay? So in the detailed discussion your fill command. So when you study the fill command, we have discussed the detail. This is the across worksheet. Okay. So this is the selection method. And now you can select the any type of the data quickly. Right? And today we have discussed many some shortcuts. This is like Control A, Control Shift, and Control Shift down arrow, right arrow, Control plus home, like that. So if you want to see the complete shortcut details, not a shortcut details, it's just like in future I have discussed about the conditional formatting. After some days you have forget this topic, but need to recover this topic. That time just cursor of the above options and see the screen tips. You can understand from screen tips. Now, what you want to do, want to see the detail, you can also go to the tell me more. When you click the tell me more, open the Excel help. But many people not use this type of the facility, Excel help. He use the Google. When you search your problem in the Google give you the many results, but result is not a full proofread. Because you can get the result from some website or some article, not a Microsoft proofread. But in the Excel help, every detail, every functions have a proofread. So I request you, if you have stuck any command, you can search on the Excel help. You can also search here and also press the Excel F1 is the shortcut of the Excel help. You can see here the completely details with also videos. But this is online, not offline. So when you search, need to internet connection. Okay? Listen, I want to search the Excel limitation. I I can also see the complete limitation of the axle. You can also search here limits. Limits, press the enter. You got the results. The accelerations and limits, your results. Click here and we can also see it. So today homework is, first you can read the Excel limits, okay? You cannot memorize, but casually read it. Well, this is the important, because this is the limitation of the Excel. Just like open the workbook, the how many work open in the one time, like that. We have opened the three workbook. This is the limited by this available memory and system resource. Some people say the unlimited, but I told you nothing in unlimited in the computer, because every moment and every action need to hard disk space. A small, but need to hard disk space. And your hard disk, your RAM is not unlimited. Okay? So limit is not defined, depend the system capacity. And also here sheet tab, number of sheets. Sheets in the, how many sheets in the workbook, same here. The limit is not defined, depend on system capacity. Okay? This is the limitation. Like that, some people ask me, how many nest formula nest in the Excel? If we have applied just like nested if one if one if in the again next if, how many if included entered in the one cell? So this is a not have a limit, but in the cell have a limit. In the cell you have typed the 32,767 characters. So when your formula reach the 32,767 character, after that you can't enter any character, any formulas. Okay? So please read it. Now we discuss the shortcut. What is shortcut? Every features have a two way for the apply. Just like you want to apply the copy, you can also click on the copy on the menu bar. And also you have applied the Control C. The Control C, the shortcut, and you can also press the copy or a command. Okay? So every features have a two way. So how can know that this feature have the which shortcut? So we have the two way. One way, first way, go over the cursor on the your function command, you can see the notes and also shortcut. But this is the very critical if you want to create the one list. So second thing is that open the Excel help and search here shortcut. Is this keyword shortcut in Excel? And this is the complete list of the Excel shortcut. Complete list. Okay? Complete list. And what some command not have a shortcut. How can apply that? Just like we have applied the all border. But on the all border, no have any shortcut. How can apply? Through the keyword. That time we have go through the menu bar. So press the Alt key. When you press the Alt key, your menu bar will be activated. Okay? Like that. And I want to apply the border. So border in the home tab. So first need to go home tab. And for the going the home tab, have a shortcut H. This character is the shortcut. So press the H. Every menu bar feature activated and every feature have a one character for shortcut. Then we apply the border. Border shortcut is the B. So press the B. your border will be activated and we have applied the all border to A. So with this is a shortcut, I'll memorize the shortcut. H4 home, Alt, H4 home, B4 border, A4 all border. Okay? So next time we have just memorized Alt H B A. Right, sir? So some feature have a direct shortcut, but some feature have a not a direct shortcut. So if you have not shortcut, then we can go through this method. Okay, sir. So for first you have try here. I have not used the shortcut in the training because you can see my computer screen only, not a keyboard. So I have apply any shortcut, so you can't memorize. I have this function I have applied. So in the training session we have used we have do the completely with mouse. But in the first class we have discussed in the shortcut. So I give you the shortcut idea, where you get the shortcut, print out the shortcut and read it and practice it, because this is not a memorable. If you have memorized control S is the workbook shortcut. So you can't use it. Then you practice. After then daily 1 day, 2 day practice without the mouse, that is after 2, 3, 4 months you have the command on the shortcut. Okay? So this is the shortcut. So today is the topic is the selection method and also Excel help, getting the Excel help.